Hey everybody, this is Ori from AstroWeb, and I'm going to show you in this video how to create simple digital downloads for your Shopify app. So what does that mean, digital downloads? If your store, if your shop is selling digital products, so for example, you're selling like some kind of PDF or some kind of course or something that's digital, right? It's not physical. You don't ship it physically within the mail. Someone purchases something and they get access to something. That's what you call a digital download, right? So maybe you made a song, someone pays $1, $2, $10, whatever it is. And then they actually can go and download that specific product. So there's a lot of apps in the app store for this, but I'm going to cover in this video the most simple one. It's free and it's made by Shopify and it's called Digital Downloads. So let's kind of walk you through how it looks, what you get out of the box. Really, really simple. And then you also might want to consider some more complicated thing via third-party apps and paid things, but I want to show you the starting point. Okay. So what you want to do first of all is you want to go to the Shopify app store, just search for digital downloads and find the one by Shopify, okay? And so you're gonna go and add the app and you're gonna install it, right? It's free, pretty straightforward. Okay, so I'm gonna install it. And what I'm gonna do right now is I'm actually gonna first of all go ahead and create a product. So I'll show you some of my basic stuff. So first of all, before I create the product, sorry, one thing. Settings. So you have email templates. So first of all, when someone actually orders and pays for the order, the system is going to send them emails automatically to tell them about their order and tell them how to download their product. So you really have some basic settings. So first of all, number one is after they pay, if you click on attachment, excuse me, after they pay, they're going to get this downloads ready email. So what that means is after they get a thank you email, thank you for your order email, right after that, they're going to get this email, which you can customize the subject line and the words to basically say, hey, here's your download link, click here, and then you can get your file, right? You already paid for it. If you've seen some of our other videos, when you customize templates, you'll have these kind of variables, these things that plug in, you know, for example, the customer first name, the customer last name, the product name, things like that. So you have all the things on the right. If you want to put in the shop name, for example, you just copy it, put it where you want. It's pretty simple. Okay. The second thing you have in the settings is sometimes you want to sell a product that is changing over time. So for example, if I am selling a subscription for a magazine or something like that, every time I update the magazine, for example, once a month, or maybe like there's a version, like version 1, 2, 3, 4, if I update that, which you'll see later, I just literally upload my file again, for example, MP3 or PDF. Anytime it gets updated, the customer will get another email. You can edit that email and say, hey, we've updated it. You can go and download the latest version. Okay, it looks pretty much the same. So before we actually go to the management of the orders, let's go and create a product. So I'm going to go to products, normal Shopify stuff, and I'm going to go add product, and I'm going to make something. So I'm going to, for example, sell my song, right? So let's call it morning MP3. So if I made something, okay, this is my morning singing, okay, something like that. And I'm going to go, obviously I'm going to make, you know, put my pictures, my pricing, everything. So I'm just going to make up something, right? So $2.99, I'm not going to upload an image right now. And I'm going to go here, put some inventory, for example, you don't have to, and I'm going to uncheck, this is a physical product. I'm going to uncheck it because I'm not shipping something physical and I don't want customers in the checkout phase to do more work than they need to. So they're only going to fill in the billing information and they can proceed. So it saves them a lot or some time, maybe a lot, maybe some. And no variations, nothing. So I finished it and I click on save. Okay. Once I do that, I have a normal product. I didn't do anything with the actual app we just made. So if I view this product, you can see it's a normal product. I can just buy, check out, but actually nothing happens. So if I check out with a default Shopify side, I can buy it and that's it. Nothing happens. You'd actually have to manually fulfill something, right? Something digital or virtual. So now I need to go to the next step, which is go to the app, right? And I have this morning MP3. I'm going to copy the name. And I'm going to go to the Digital Downloads app, the one we just installed. I'm going to go to the dashboard. This is something from before, so disregard this, right? On a new installation, you wouldn't have this, okay? So what I'm gonna do is I'm going to go to, I'm gonna go to dashboard, and sorry, my mistake. I made a mistake for a second. So I'm gonna go back to the product edit, actually, and I'm gonna set it up from there. Okay, so I'm gonna go to the product, for example, here. We search for it, morning MP3, okay? And I'm gonna go here and click on more add actions, and I'm gonna actually attach the MP3, okay? So I'm gonna go here, attach it, okay? And then this is kind of the product itself. And then I go and I upload the file right here. So I'm just gonna pretend like I'm making something, some kind of MP3, so morning.mp3. Excuse me, and don't worry about this. I'm just quickly making it for an example, right? Let's just say I had some file. Okay, so now I'm gonna go upload it. Gonna go morning.mp3, and I upload it. It's gonna take a few seconds. Okay, good, and that's it. So I did this. Now, if I go back to the dashboard, now I'm ready to go. So now I have the product here, right? It comes from an actual product that has an attachment. And I can see how many times that this specific attachment has been sold and how many times has it been downloaded, right? Usually you should have the same amount of sales as downloads. So let's do it. Okay, so now I'm going to go to the product. I'm going to refresh. Now we have the product, right? So I'm going to buy it, proceed to checkout, and I'll show you what's going on. Okay, so I can do that. Now I only have to fill up the billing address because there's no actual shipment. I can go pay for it, right? Don't worry that I have cash on delivery. This is just a test site. So obviously you'd have a real processing of the payment. Once you would collect payment and move forward. So I made the order. Okay, and let me open my email. Okay, I got the order. I confirmed the order. Now, if you go to the app itself, you'll be able to see that morning MP3. Okay, so Morning MP3 has zero sales right now. And the reason for that is because we have COD, which is just cash on delivery, which is not a really accepting money, I would have to manually actually accept this order and then it would process. But with a real credit card or real payment, you don't have to do this. This is just because of this demo site in this video. So I have the order right now. Okay, and then I have it. It's unfulfilled, obviously, but I'm going to mark it as paid. So if you had a real credit card payment, Shopify payments, PayPal, any of those, you don't have to do the step I'm doing right now. I'm going to mark it as paid. Okay, now it's good. So now the order itself hasn't been fulfilled yet, but it has been paid. So if I go back to my app and I go to digital downloads, okay, it's going to take usually about 1 minute or so, and then the sales are going to actually change, okay? So do this, just check one more thing here. Okay, so one more thing I forgot to mention while we have 1 minute till it sends is you can actually specify that when someone pays, the system will automatically create the fulfillment. Basically what it would do, it was actually once it gets paid, it's gonna send an email to the customer, which I'll show you in a second, and then you know, the customer will get it. So everything is automatic. You don't have to do any kind of order processing. But if you wanted to do it yourself after they get paid, you could actually go to the order and fulfill it. But usually this is pretty good. And then also you have a download limit, right? Zero means you can download as many times or you can limit the number of clicks. Okay. So if I go here, I have, first of all, I have my normal thank you email, thank you from your order email. And then here, I actually have the email template. It says, thank you for your purchase. You can click here. If I click on this, I actually go and download the file, right? I can go here, I can click on it, and I got my file. So click, and it should download the file we just uploaded, which is correct, okay? And then if I go back to dashboard, I can see it was sold because we already got it paid for and it was delivered and someone actually clicked on the download. So we know someone collected it, okay? And you can see the same data here, right? How much Bandwidth was using, sales, download, etc. That's it, that's the whole thing. So you can see everything very simply. Other than that, if you do, let me just one more thing. If you do create this upload and you actually did decide to make it manual right here, what you would do, you have to go to the order, click on the order, and whenever you verify that they paid, etc., you would actually go and send out the attachment email. Now, we've already sent it because you saw in my inbox here, but you'd have to send it first time. And then if you want, you can always send it again. So hope you enjoy this video. Let me know if you have any questions. I appreciate your time. Thank you very much.